Eternal Father, I offer you the body and the blood.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the love and mercy of God be with you. Let us pray. Loving and merciful Father, out of your compassion, you sent us your merciful Son, Jesus Christ, to demonstrate to us your mercy and love towards us, especially the sinners. We beg you that you may send us your Holy Spirit to continue and bring to accomplishment that work of healing, of deliverance, of liberation, and of salvation that your Son began here on earth. This is a prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew chapter 15, verses 29-37. At that time, Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, and he went up on the mountain and sat down there. And great crowds came to him, bringing with them the lame, the maimed, the blind, the mute, and many others. And they put them at his feet, and he healed them, so that the throng wondered. When they saw the mute speaking, the maimed whole, the lame walking, and the blind seeing, and they glorified the God of Israel. Then Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I have compassion on the crowd, because they have been with me now 3 days, and have nothing to eat, and am unwilling to send them away hungry, lest they faint on the way. And the disciples said to him, Where are we to get bread enough in the desert to feed so great a crowd? And Jesus said to them, How many loaves have you? They said, 7, and a few small fish. And commanding the crowd to sit down on the ground, he took the 7 loaves and the fish, and having given thanks, he broke them and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowds. And they all ate and were satisfied. And they took up 7 baskets full of the broken pieces left over. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear good listener, a good Wednesday of Advent to you. Today, I've chosen the theme, the compassionate heart of Jesus. My dear good listener, from the Gospel we have heard, Jesus demonstrates to his people the compassionate heart he has. From Luke chapter 6, verse 36, God is merciful. That's why Jesus in that text tells us, be merciful as your Father is merciful. In the gospel of today, Jesus, after healing the people, after preaching to the crowds, he realizes that they are hungry and tells his disciples, I have compassion on the crowd because they have been with me now 3 days and have nothing to eat, and I'm unwilling to send them away hungry. My dear good listener, Jesus does not want to send you hungry. He does not want to send you thirsty. He does not want to send you sick. He wants you whole. In the text we have heard, we come to understand exactly what Jesus meant in John chapter 10, verse 10, when he said, I have come that my sheep may have life and have it to its fullness. Yes, we see in the gospel of today, Jesus preaches to the crowds for 3 days. He heals all those who are lame, maimed, the blind, the mute, all of those who are sick and needed his healing. He healed all of them. But he still realized they had a certain hunger. They still needed to be fed. And Jesus says, I'm unwilling to send them hungry. And so he says, I have compassion on the crowd. We see therefore the compassionate heart of Jesus, that he never wants to send people away hungry, to send people away thirsty. He is a God who feels with us. And so what we see is that the compassion, which I would say is a feeling, it is a Jesus who feels with the people. Why? Because he is merciful. So compassion, therefore, is a manifestation of the mercy that God has for us. And mercy is a fulfillment of the compassionate heart of Jesus. And so we see Jesus in his mercy asking his disciples what they have to give. They only had 5 loaves of bread and a few fish. And so Jesus uses these He blesses them. He thanks his Father and he gives them out. He gives out the compassion of God. My dear good listener, in her diary number 526, Saint Faustina is told by Jesus, "This is how you and your compassions are going to be clothed. My life from birth to death on the cross will be the rule for you. Fix your eyes upon me and live according to what you say. I desire that you penetrate into my spirit more deeply and understand that I'm meek and humble of heart." Therefore, this heart of Jesus that is humble and meek displays to us the mercy of God. And in her diary number 528, St. Faustina says, "On Friday, during Mass, when my soul was flooded with God's happiness, I heard these words in my soul, 'My mercy has passed into souls through the divine human heart of Jesus as a ray from the sun passes through crystal.' I felt in my heart and understood that every approach to God is brought about by Jesus in him and through him. Therefore, my dear good listener, may we hearken to Jesus. Through him, in him, and with him, we shall reach the mercy of God, passing through the compassionate heart of Jesus. May we pray, therefore, that you and I, God may fill us with that mercy. And may we also learn to be compassionate as Jesus is compassionate. May we also see Jesus in the sick, in the lame, in the maimed, in the blind. May we see Jesus in those who suffer and demonstrate God's mercy by being compassionate. The Lord be with you. And may the God of love and mercy bless you, the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, Lord Jesus.